want to thank everybody for coming out today, and also just the help throughout the season. Our staff, everyone has helped to make this season possible. Also, a shout out to our staff that's in attendance today.
Everybody, come on, guys.
Tonight, NJCAA Region 21 matchup is between the visiting Roxbury Giants and your Bristol Bayhawks. According to the rules of the NJCAA and Region 21, spectators, please consider the time and effort each team put forth and allow the participants to build pride in their communities and schools. And now for tonight's starting lineups. First, with the visiting Roxbury Giants. At guard, number 0, Shamar Donaldson. At the other guard, number 2, Michael Benedetto. At forward, number 12, Jacob Harris. At forward, number 20, Michael Correa. And at center, number 31, A.L. Escobar. And now, for your Bristol
thank you. good evening and welcome to Bayhawks Night here from the Taunton Center here in Taunton, Massachusetts, a.k.a. the Hawk's Nest. I am your announcer, David Cardoza. No Keith tonight. So sad. Here's a tip. And Roxbury will win the tip. Bayhawks here tonight in their white uniforms with the gray trimming. Roxbury in black with the orange. Rebound off the tip. Upping off the miss there by Aiden Rock. Bayhawks coming into tonight's game, 14-9. Farnsworth back up to Rock from the top, three-pointer. It's good! On sophomore night, Aiden Rock with a three-pointer from the top, and the Bayhawks have a 3-0 lead. Jumper in the lane, way off the mark. Loose ball. And they're going to call travel. Roxbury turns the ball over, and Bristol will regain possession. A lot of energy in the building tonight. Like I said, Bayhawks night, honoring our sophomores in one of their last games of their Bayhawks career. Glad for you to join us on all of our platforms, including here on YouTube, live streaming. Morin loses it in the post. Roxbury on the break, laying it in. Laying it in, that was number zero, Shamar Browder. Oh, Morin, nice pass underneath to Rock. Nice find there by Morin, finds Rock. And Bristol's up 5-2 here in the early going. Again, I'm David Cardoza on the call. Stolen there by Morin. Morin on the break. Open pass to the basket. Misses the slam. Looked like Morin just didn't have enough air underneath there. Had the easy two. Went for the slam and came up a little bit short, so to speak. They swing it around. The jumper from the elbow. It's good. Shot made there by number two, Michael DeLeon. And the Tigers are within one. Farnsworth, round the back. Gets to the basket with the left hand. Beautiful move by Curran Farnsworth. And Bristol's up 7-4. Pick his pocket. White to the basket, lays it in. Nice steal there, picked his pocket. And Bristol up 9-4. Bristol holds it on to the fourth spot here in Region 21. They hold one of the top four spots. Underneath, the basket is good by number 12 there, Jacob Harris. And we're only a few minutes in, but this game has been up and down. Rock pulls back, three-pointer, short. Rebounded by the little guy, Browder. All the way. And Marcus White caught Browder's shot. Looked like he was on the line. They're going to say he was out of bounds. And Shamar Browder, the point guard, number zero, will inbound for the Tigers underneath their own basket. As the Bayhawks match up man-to-man, they try to double-team in the corner. Short jumper, no good. Rebounded by Morin. Farnsworth. White, that's his spot. Coming off, no good. Rebounded by Jacob Harris. Both teams playing with tremendous energy and tremendous pace here in the early going. Bristol, they want to play fast. Jumper, no good by Browder. Rebound was by Rock. And now Farnsworth decides to slow up the pace a little bit. Nine-six, Bristol with the lead. White into the lane, strong take. Just can't get it to fall. Rebounded by Browder. I'm sorry, by Harris. There's Browder. Oh, nice reverse. Lays it up and in. And the Tigers pull within one, 9-8. Roxbury in the black and orange, playing man-to-man. Barnworth now goes into the post. Morin, oh, fights Rock underneath. Yeah, nice drive to the basket there by Morin. Finds Aiden Rock all alone underneath. Sweet dish there by Morin. He's got a couple assists so far in his first half. Aiden Rock has 5 points so far. To the basket with the left hand is Harris. He can't connect. White, look at the push. Ooh, nice bounce pass. Hayden Caton streaking towards the basket on the break, and he gets fouled. And he'll go to the line for two. I like the way Bristol is playing right now with pace and playing fast. That's when Bristol plays at their best. Hayden Caton being honored here earlier by Coach Fernandez. Here on sophomore night, Bayhawks night. The young man from Swansea, Massachusetts, hits both free throws, extends the lead for Bristol by five. Loud in here on a Thursday night. They kick it back out. Browder puts it up with the left. Can't get it to go. And Camden Morin pulls down the rebound. Morin in space. And they're going to say Marcus White stepped out of bounds. To 8, 14-23 to play here in the first half. Only one foul so far by either team, and it was on Roxbury. Jumper falling away in the corner by DeLeon, can't get it to go. Rock driving baseline, nice dish by Rock to Kagan, he got his stuff blocked. Browder, the floater, no good. Rebound by Rock. White to the basket. Oh, goodness gracious. Little awkward step there by White in the open court. And then going back the other way, they're going to call a charge on Jacob Harris. Second team foul on Bristol. Hayden Caton took the charge, and he'll actually step out of the game. And now Marquise Pina will come in for Hayden Caton. Stolen away. Browder in the open court on the pass from Harris. Can't connect on the layup. And Roxbury turns the ball over. We're coming up on the 13-minute mark. Farnworth being guarded by Browder. Rock flashes to the paint. Follow-away jumper, no good. Rebounded by Harris. Harris kicks it to the corner. All alone for three, it's good. All alone for three is Michael DeLeon. Coach Fernandez will call a timeout. And it is 13-11 here in the early going. Timeout on the floor. And we'll take a timeout here on FRC Media, your Bayhawks broadcasting network. All right, after a little break, we're still in a timeout. Bayhawks called a timeout after that three-pointer there by Michael DeLeon. .12:57 here to play here in the first half. We got a packed house. We got the president here. Not the president of the United States, but the president of Bristol. All right, coming out of the timeout, 13-11. Farnworth with the basketball. Farnworth gets it stolen there by Browder. Browder buzzing like a bee in the open court. The floater gets it to go, gets the roll. Browder gets the friendly bounce, and we're tied at 13. Pena gets double teamed, gets it stolen away. Browder in the open court. Can't get the layup to fall. Rebounded by Pena. Now White to the basket. Oh, almost tipped home by Rock. Can't get it to fall though. Look at the way they're moving the basketball. Basket on the other end by number 20, Michael Correa. His first points of the game. And the first lead of the game for the Tigers. Rock for three. Can't get it to fall. Harris up to Browder. Lays it in. And Roxbury is on a 9-0 run. Farnworth, clear pass to the basket. But loses it out of bounds, but they're going to say it's off the Tigers. 17-13. It was all Bristol. Bristol got on the board first. They had a 13-8 lead. And the Tigers have a 9-0 lead. They went on a 9-0 run, I should say. Morin spinning in the paint, loses it. Another turnover by Bristol. Harris to DeLeon, can't connect. Both teams pushing it down each other's throats. Another steal there by Browder. The alley-oop, can't connect on the slam though, is Harris. And the ball goes out of bounds. It's going to be off the Tigers. And the Bayhawks will gather possession. Been a wild one here in the early going. White gets it into Rock. And I think they count the basket. Wait for Aiden Rock to get underneath there and get physical. He put his shoulder into Harris. Harris trying to plead his case, looking for the offensive foul, but Aiden Rock will go to the line, and he'll connect for a three-point play. He's got eight. There's Aiden Rock. Three-pointer by Harris is short. Rebounded by Morin. Deep three by Pena, knocks it down. Marquise P, 4-3. And the Bayhawks regain the lead. They're up by two. Oh, nice little stutter step there by Browder. And the floater is good. Nice little nifty move there by the point guard. And we're deadlocked at 19. White to the basket. Try to go up and under. Can't get it to fall. And the rebound by Aiden Rock. Gets the offensive rebound and the two. Aiden Rock has come to play. The sophomore captain getting it done. Browder, the short jumper from the free throw line is good. And this game is back and forth. 21-21. Marquise P. Can't get it to fall. Michael DeLeon. stolen away by Pina. And we got substitutions on the court. Number 12, Jacob Harris, will go out. Number 31, Adiel Escobar comes in. And also number 25, Dai Iwanami. Short jumper just outside the paint by Rock. And he's got 12. He's the lead scorer for either team. Ooh, how did he get through there? Whoa, what a move there by Shamar Browder. And we're deadlocked again at 23. Here's number 23, Farnworth. Farnworth and Browder, this is a fun matchup. Rock, three-pointer, knocks it down! The Rock, the captain, the sensational sophomore, knocks down the three. They give Browder space. Jumper's no good. Up high for the rebound is Pina. Pina, long pass into the hands of the Tigers. Bristol holding on to a 26-23 lead. Good ball movement there by the Tigers. Three-pointer, in and out. Rebounded by Morin. Ooh, driving. Oh, Camden Morin on the pass from Marcus White. Gets the friendly roll. Look like we have a Tiger over here hurt. ADL Escobar, number 31, limping back the other way. Camden Morin looking for the three-point play. Can't get it to fall, follows his own shot. Nice pass underneath to White. White can't connect. Still, Bayhawks still with possession. White underneath to Morin. Aiden Rock from deep. Three! He's feeling it! He is feeling it! Aiden Rock for three. And Bristol just like that, up by eight. Underneath, Escobar can't connect. Bristol continually looking to push. Farnworth kicks it back out. Again, Rock for three. It's good! He's unconscious! He's unconscious right now. Aiden Rock with another trifecta. And he's just wrecking the game right now. Floater by Browder, can't get it to fall. Rock in the zone. Rock to the basket. Can't get it to fall this time. But Bristol up 11. From the wing. Can't knock it down. Morin. Gets it knocked away by who else? Browder. On the floor is who else? Aiden Rock. The hustler. If there's anyone that embodies, that exemplifies the slogan here at Bristol College of grit, G-R-I-T, it's Aiden Rock. 34-23, Bayhawks on 11-0 run, and they have no team fouls. Bayhawks have not committed one personal foul. The alley-oop. Oh! Aiden Rock doing it all. The pass to Morin, who did a beautiful job. Three-pointer, no good. Rock is just all over the place. Oh, nice entry pass inside. Morin can't get it to fall. Going back the other way. And they'll turn the ball over. Yeah, Morin. Morin earlier, the pass from Aiden Rock. The way Morin was able to go up there and somehow get that to go. That was amazing. Farnsworth loses it off his foot. Tigers with the basketball. Up to Harris. Looked like he got contact there, but either way, scores the two. Rock again for three. Can't get it to fall. Rebounded by Marcus White. Marcus White tried to get it to Rock, but it was stolen away by Harris. Loose ball on the floor. Marquise Pena comes away with it. Marquise Pena through traffic, lays it up and in. Marquise P, number three, with the deuce. 38-25, Bristol with its largest lead yet, led by Aiden Rock. In the paint. Oh, what a shot there. By Geronimo Patino. How did he get that one to fall? That was excellent. Coming up on the 4.5 minute mark here in the first half. It's been an entertaining one from the Hawks desk, from the Taunton Center, home of your Bristol Bayhawks. White to his left, fadeaway jumper, no good. Rebounded by Harris. They swing it around the perimeter. Harris for three, gets it to go. Oh boy, did the Tigers need that one. They needed to stop the bleeding. That's a big three by Harris. Pulls the Tigers within eight. Farnsworth will walk the ball up. Finds Morin underneath to Rock. Good job there. And Bristol is up by 10. Timeout on the floor. And we'll take a break here. 3:52, 40-30. Both teams, you know, they had a couple lead changes there. Both teams tied the score back and forth. It was tied at 23, and then Bristol went on a 11-0 run. And now that the way it stands now, Bristol has a 40-30 lead. Aiden Rock leading the way. 17 points for him. He's a leading scorer for the Bayhawks or for either team. Here in the first half, he's been tremendous. Bristol comes out with their starting five. Well, minus Hayden Caton, he started the game, actually. Marquise Pena has taken his place. Okay, so Roxbury will inbound the basketball. They trail by 10 here in this very important Region 21 matchup. Three-pointer. Looks like it's coming off. It does. Rebounded by Rock. He's done an amazing job on the boards. Rock goes into the paint. Oh, misses the layup. That was a good give and go. Rock just couldn't get it to fall. Three-pointer. In and out. Offensive rebound and put back by Harris. And the Tigers are back within eight. Roxbury matching up man-to-man. Coming up on 3 minutes to play. Aiden Rock for three. Can't get it to fall. He's gone cold here the last few trips up the floor. Browder driving to the paint. Kicks it back out. Three-pointer. It's good by Harris. And just like that, the Tigers have climbed back into within five. Don't count them out just yet. I love the way Bristol's playing right now. They're playing fast. Nice little underhand flip there by Morin, driving into the paint and scoring. Bristol up by 7. Bristol has done a great job offensively, moving the basketball, playing fast with pace. Being unselfish with the basketball and taking smart shots. Morin. Try to impose his will. That shot's way off, though. Good defense by Harris. There's Browder. And that could be the first team foul. Looks like it. First team foul for Bristol. And it was in the act of shooting. So Shamar Browder, number 0. He will go to the line for 2. That foul is on Aiden Rock. And very important that that young man stays out of foul trouble. Hayden Caton will come in for Marquise Pena. He'll take a seat. Browder makes the first free throw. Again, only one team foul for Bristol. Both free throws are good by Shamar Browder. 5-point lead. As this first half winds down in a very entertaining first half here in Taunton. Browder into the paint, knocked away. Ooh. Farnsworth for 3! Curran Farnsworth from deep. Extends the lead to 8 for Bristol. Big shot there by Farnsworth. DeLeon for 3. Coming out the side of the rim. Trying to save it was Harris, but it goes right into the hands of Farnsworth. Farnsworth to White, streaking. And the reverse lay-in is good by Marcus White. And Bristol is back up to a double-digit lead with a minute left here in the first half. Around the perimeter. The step back. Can't get the bounce. Rebounded by Curran Farnsworth. If I'm Bristol, I'm going to slow the pace up. Actually, they might go for a 2-for-1 here. And they might just do that. The lay-in by Marcus White. Around the back. Marcus White with a little dipsy-do move there. That was beautiful. And now Bristol will try to get a defensive stop here. Oh, but Harris White knocks it down. And he looks at his palm. What's going on there? 49-40. Bristol will hold for the final shot of the first half. Or at least that's the plan. Bristol, 9-point lead. White to his left. Farnsworth loses it. It's on the floor. Caton. And Bristol will not be able to get a shot off. Well, ladies and gentlemen, here on Bayhawks night, sophomore night, Bristol has a 9-point lead, Aiden Rock. That young man did a heck of a job and here in the first half. So on sophomore night, we'll take it in. It's halftime here at the Taunton Center. Join us for a great second half action. We'll see you in a little bit.
At Bristol, a quality, affordable education is always within reach. We're here to help you navigate how to pay for college. 68% of new incoming students at Bristol graduate without debt. The primary way students pay for college is through financial aid. Financial aid includes grants, work-study programs, and loans. You can apply for financial aid by completing the free application for federal student aid. Based on your needs, FAFSA can often cover tuition and fees, housing and food, books and supplies, as well as transportation. Applying for financial aid is free and it's easier than it sounds. Visit studentaid.gov to apply today. The FAFSA is accepted all year, but be sure to file as soon as possible so you can take advantage of more grants versus loans. Need help? our financial aid counselors can assist. Visit bristolcc.edu/financial aid to meet the team and to make an appointment. One type of financial aid you may be awarded through FAFSA is grants. Unlike loans, grants are sources of financial aid that generally don't have to be repaid. More than 49% of Bristol students receive Pell Grants. If you are a Massachusetts resident aged 25 years or older, check out the Mass Reconnect program. You may qualify for additional financial aid. Learn more at bristolcc.edu/massreconnect. Another type of aid is work study. Work study can not only help you pay for school, but it can be utilized to help gain professional experience. Scholarships are another great way to pay for college because they also don't have to be repaid. Scholarships are financial support awarded to a student based on academic achievement or other criteria that may include financial need. Check out scholarship opportunities at bristolcc.edu/scholarships@bristol. If you're a veteran, the Joseph A. Marshall Veterans Center can help you maximize your education benefits. Meet with our Veterans Center team to learn more. To help you budget your educational expenses, set up a convenient budget with a no-interest monthly payment plan through the college. Once you've exhausted all sources of free aid and payment plans, federal and private loans are available. Keep in mind, these must be repaid. Federal loans will be detailed in your financial aid packet, while private loans you'll have to seek out on your own. And remember, if you plan on transferring, we've got you covered too. With more than 75 credit transfer agreements with four-year colleges and universities, you can save thousands by starting at Bristol.
Hello, my name is Victoria Robidoux, and I am the class of 2023's salutatorian. I went to a vocational high school, and so I am a licensed cosmetologist. I went through the cosmetology program. And having a vocational high school background, you leave with a skill. So you can enter the workforce right away. So in combination, I think, with not knowing what I wanted to do and having this skill to fall back on, I didn't know what the right path was. So I put school off for a while. It took me about 10 years to go back to school. And so it was a bit daunting getting back into it and finding out who I was as a student again. I decided that, you know, I had spent a lot of time outside of school, so I was going to really laser focus on it. So I packed my schedule and was able to complete my degree in a year and a half in history. I started at Bristol fully online. I started as a biology major and I wanted to go into horticulture. But within my first semester, I found that it wasn't quite aligning with what I really wanted to do. And having the opportunity to write more and the positive feedback that I got from my professors made me realize that I could pursue writing and could pursue something a bit more fulfilling for myself. After my first semester, I was invited to join the honors program, and that allowed me to be a bit more involved. Being able to come into the classroom opened new possibilities for me. I felt more involved in my classwork. And so through the honors program, I was then invited to join PTK and keep up my grades and feel more confident about that and more confident about my next step in education. So my personal interests and my career path definitely resides in studying mortuary traditions and being a death educator. So last semester I founded the Mortals Club here at Bristol, and as the acting president I have been recruiting members to have what's viewed as taboo conversations to explore our ideas about death and our anxieties and how we can be more connected as a community through it. After Bristol, I plan on getting a bachelor's degree in anthropology and work my way up to a PhD and just continue on in that field. It's just the most exciting, interesting thing to me. I'm Victoria Robidoux, class of 2023 salutatorian, and you can make it happen at Bristol Community College.
It's time to make it happen at Bristol Community College. Because I can graduate debt-free.
Because a degree will take my career to the next level.
I want to set an example for my girls.
A career change will lead to more time at home.
Because my job experience counts for college credit, I'm making it happen.
I'm making it happen.
I'm making it happen at Bristol Community College.
I graduated from Bristol in 2008 from the communications program. And after Bristol, I went to Salem State University. I moved from Jersey City, New Jersey, which was very Hispanic, at the end of 1997. So I came into the middle of sixth grade to a school where I didn't know anybody. I didn't feel like I fit in. It was kind of lonely at times. After graduating high school, I came to Bristol and immediately I just felt welcomed. So community is very important to me. I wanted other people to feel the same way. I came across E4All back in 2019 as an entrepreneur. E4All is a nonprofit organization. We help businesses start, grow, or pivot. I went through the program, and then in 2020, I started working as staff. In the years that I've been an entrepreneur, I've done a lot of networking. I didn't see a lot of people that looked like me. I kind of started wondering, you know, why aren't people that look like me going to networking events? It's so important to really connect with the community and create relationships, business relationships. I decided to just start the group myself. So Latinos in the South Coast is a networking group for Latina professionals, small business owners, and Hispanic-led organizations. It's open to everybody, of course, but my main focus was really to empower the Latina professional. It's just been so great to connect everybody, build these relationships, and everyone just gets so much support, and it's so great to see. It just makes my heart warm because that's exactly why I wanted to do it. South Coast Hispanic Chamber of Commerce came out of Latinas in the South Coast. So really we're coming in and continuing to offer support specifically to the Hispanic community. The point of Latinas in the South Coast and the Hispanic Chamber is to really have folks in the community feel comfortable and able to express themselves in a safe environment. It's been great working with entrepreneurs.
My senior year of high school, I decided I was gonna play football. I had a bad injury then. I dislocated my shoulder, broke my collarbone, and that was it for me. So I got right into the workforce. I started doing construction. I found out about a semi-pro football team that we had here in New Bedford. And I realized, you know what? It's not the end for me. This is my opportunity to play football again. I play tight end. And I fell in love with the sport even more. From 2008 to 2016 is when my injury occurred. I played for the semi-pro team around the area. Having a traumatic injury playing in a football game, I had a neck fracture, which sent me to Rhode Island Hospital. Then they sent me out to Spalding Rehab. I had to relearn how to walk, talk, do everything all over again. I was not upset with where I was. I was okay. I accepted the fact that I couldn't move, but I can talk. And because I had my child, I said, as long as we can communicate, I would be fine. 2 weeks before I left, I started thinking, wow, I'm really not moving yet. Then I met a great physical therapist there that she believed in me. She had all the faith and it was everything that I needed. She stood me up for the first time by myself on a parallel bar. I seen that photo and that inspired me. I said, you know, I'm standing and now we're gonna get moving. By the time I left, I was walking about 50 feet, but for me to independently walk by myself would give it about 3 to 4 months. That feeling of losing the ability to just do anything, to being able to stand again, it was amazing. It was like, the best feeling in the world. When I left Spalding, I was going to outpatient therapy, and that's when I started to develop this love for therapy, because I was relearning everything and everything became so interesting to me. So when I found out that Bristol had an occupational therapy assistant program, I was like, okay, that's my opportunity to go back to school. It was just a game changer from there. It was challenging, but at the same time, it was very interesting. I started understanding why my body was, or is the way it is now with having hemiparesis. Like, the love for the sport was just so strong, and now it's something that I can't do, but I'm hoping that at some point in life, maybe get into coaching, working with the youth.
We're back here on this Bayhawks night. I'm David Cardoza here on the call. Michelle D bringing you the fancy camera work. And on the tech support, we got the man behind the magic, Steve Reese. Aiden Rock, 24 points, leads all scorers for Bristol. Behind him, 8 points for Curran Farnsworth. Shamar Browder for Roxbury, the leading scorer in Region 21. He has 16. All right, we got some big time Bristol College officials in the house. We got El Presidente, Laura Douglas in the house. As we get underway here in the second half, I want to thank our audience for watching our live stream here tonight on a very important night for these sophomores for Bristol. That would be Aiden Rock and Hayden Caton. Those two being honored here earlier tonight. As we roll towards postseason play, backing in is White. Goes to the fadeaway, comes up short. Rebounded by Harris. Harris, he had 15 points for the Tigers in the first half. Harris, three-pointer, it's good. Actually, they're gonna say that's a two just inside the three-point line. He has 17. Morin thought about it, kicks it to Kagan. Three-pointer by Morin, it's short. And it's gonna go off Aiden Rock. And it'll be Roxbury basketball. 49-42. Crowder kicks it back out, three-pointer. No good by Korea. Roxbury starting off here man-to-man. They switch. They try to get it inside to Morin, stolen away by Harris. Harris. And they're gonna call a travel there. If it wasn't gonna be a travel, it was definitely gonna be a charge. He was gonna smash right into him. 49-42. Bristol with a 7-point lead. Kagan tries to get into the paint, stolen away by Browder. Browder in transition up to Korea. And he gets fouled, he's limping, he's gonna go to the line for two. First half was dominated by four players, two on each team, Shamar Browder and Jacob Harris. And then on the Bristol side, I mean, Aiden Rock, 24 points. Curran Farnworth was the second leading scorer with eight. Other than that, a lot of scarcity as far as points go. One of two made there by Korea, 6-point lead. A lot of time to go here. Don't go away. Marcus White lobs it in. Morin. I believe that pass hit the underneath of the basket, the underside of the basket. Goes out of bounds. And the Tigers with the basketball. Browder, the floater in the lane. Gets his own rebound and lays it up and in. He's got 18. Roxbury, just when you think they're dead and out of it, they're hanging around. Farnworth into the paint, gets it blocked. Lots of contact there. And they're gonna say it's Bristol basketball. Bristol coming into tonight's contest, 14-9. In a little bit of a tailspin, they've lost a couple games here over the last week, but they still hold on to that number four spot. In Region 21. 49-45. Bristol has a four-point lead. Roxbury with the basketball. Roxbury, like I said, they will not go away. Bristol had a nine-point lead at halftime. It is now four. Korea, up fake. Being guarded closely by Aiden Rock. Router, round the back. Try to go amongst the bigs, loses it. And I believe they're going to call a foul. Who's it on? They're going to call it on number 22, Camden Morin. Underneath their own basket, Korea catches. Pulls it back out. DeLeon for three, can't get it to fall. Rebound by the little man. Browder, he's got 20. The drive and kick to Marcus P, the floater. It's good. Marcus P, number three with the deuce. Bristol still up four. Getting hot and heated in this gymnasium. Here on Bayhawks night, Korea pulls up from the free throw line. And he's going to get fouled. Going to the line and shooting two will be number 20, Michael Korea. And Michael Korea wills that one home. Both free throws made by Korea. It is now a two-point game. Bristol was up as many as 13 in the first half. The jumper, Pina, can't get it to fall. Rebounded by Harris, tough rebound. Looks ahead to DeLeon, puts it above the glass and in, and it is a tie game here in Taunton. 51-51. Into the lane is Farnworth. Regains the lead quickly for Bristol. Bristol doing a great job keeping their composure. Roxbury keeps coming, but Bristol keeps having the answers. The drive, the kick to the corner, three-pointer, air ball. What a block there by Morin. And then there's contact after the play, and they're going to call a foul there. And the foul's going to be on Browder. And the Bayhawks have the lead in possession. Three-pointer by White, sinks it! Marcus White for three. And Bristol back up by five. Browder buzzing like a bee, into the paint, like a Swiss Army knife. Going through Swiss cheese. Browder, all the way to the basket. White lays it up and in, score it. It's action-packed to the basket. What a block there by Farnworth. I'll tell you what, that Shamar Browder, he's a heck of a player. Showing off the handles, the way he's able to get into the paint, he's undersized, the way that he's just able to get in there and score is amazing. They kick it back out. Harris thought about it. Pulls it back for three. Can't get it to fall underneath. Oh, what a basket there by Korea. And it's a three-point lead, 58-55. Here's Rock. Kicks it to the corner. Pina, I'm sorry, Farnsworth. And they're going to call a reach-in foul. Well, I think they're going to call that on. Who they call that on? The number 13, Geronimo Patino. Second foul for him. Three for the Tigers. Two team fouls for the Bayhawks as we come up to the 14-minute mark in this very important NJCAA, a Region 21 matchup. Bristol looking for their 15th win of the season. Shot in the corner is no good by Farnworth. Browder, which crossing over into the paint, kicks it to the corner. Harris back underneath to Browder. How does he do it? Up and in, Browder. And that young man's got 22. Timeout on the court. We'll take a timeout here. We'll catch our breath. It's 58-57. 1-point lead for Bristol. We'll be right back on our Bayhawks Broadcasting Network. going downhill and getting physical. And he'll go to the line for two. Five team fouls for the Tigers. As Bristol nears the bonus, only two team fouls for Bristol. As we come up on the halfway mark here in the second half. 67-63, Bristol with the lead. The Tigers had the lead here just a couple minutes ago, but it was short-lived. Bristol firing right back, and that's been the impressive thing about this game here tonight. Both free throws are missed by Morin. As we come up on the 10-minute mark. Don't go away, folks. Oh, nice pass inside by Harris. Oh, Korea to Browder. Oh, what a tremendous move. Browder. Shamar Browder. He's got 28. That's a deep three. White going to come up short. Browder. That quick dribble, the quick handle. Gets his own rebound, fights for it. And the man, he draws the foul. That foul is going to be on number 24. It's going to be on Marcus White. That's his second. Third team foul for Bristol with 9:36 to play. First free throw is good there by Shamar Browder. As he closes in on 30 points, a leading scorer in the conference, in Region 21. That is 30. And we're tied at 67 with 9:36 to play. What a game we have here. We'll let it breathe here for a minute as both teams are playing excellent basketball. All right, we're bringing it back to you. Here in Taunton, Massachusetts. Home of your Bristol College Bayhawks. Tied at 67. All right, Curran Farnworth will walk the ball up for the Bayhawks. Tied at 67. This has been an up and down, up and down matchup. Both teams looking to run. Both teams looking to play fast. Been a real enjoyable game to watch. Farnsworth spins around the back. Oh, almost connected with the layup. That would have been beautiful. Up to Browder from Harris. Up and around and in. Boy, what a game, Shamar Browder. Farnsworth going back the other way and gets it blocked there by Harris. And then Browder tried to save it. Shamar Browder just couldn't save it, and the Bristol will have possession. Trailing by two. Farnworth for three. Can't get it to go. Rebounded by Harris. Browder takes it into the front court. Into the lane and drawing the foul. That's going to be number two, Michael DeLeon. As he draws the foul going into the paint, foul's going to be on number 23, Curran Farnworth. That's his first. fourth team foul for Bristol. 8:43 to play here in the second half. Again, Aiden Rock been kind of quiet here in the second half. He has yet to get on the board here after a hot start. Yeah, they're going to somehow re-engage him into the game, get him back into the flow of the offense. Both free throws are good, and regaining the lead by four, the Tigers. I mean, these lead swings have just been massive. Farnworth, just like I said, get it to Rock, and he'll go to the line for two. And if you're Aiden Rock, or if you're his teammates, you got to get him the ball. He needs to reassert himself back into this game, because when he was playing at a high level, I mean, Bristol was flying high. The Bayhawks are flying high. First free throw was good, and that's his first points of the second half. We have a substitution. Marquise Pina will go out. Petruski, number 11, he'll come in. Both free throws are good by Rock. He has 26. Here's Browder, the leading scorer of all scorers. Oh, the little man going underneath. How does he do it? Oh, man. It's like he's invisible out there. 73-69. He's got 32. Shamar Browder, small in stature, but he plays big. Nice little up and under move in the paint. Getting the position is White on the inbound pass from Farnsworth. Can't get it to fall, but he will go to the free throw line. Yes, he will go to the free throw line, and now Bristol is in the bonus. That's 17 fouls. So the Tigers are in the penalty now. First part of a 1-1 is good by Marcus White as he pulls his team within three. Second free throw is good. Bristol down by two. They're going to play some lockdown defense now. Bristol's going to turn up the pressure defensively. Here's Browder. Pass underneath is stolen by Morin. Bristol looking to tie. Farmer kicks it to the corner. Rock for three, contested, it's good! Aiden Rock for three in your eyeballs. Browder was all over Rock and he shot it for three and connected. Rebounded by Rock. Aiden Rock starting to come alive. That was huge. He's got 29 around the back. Farnworth into the paint. Up with the left hand. It's good. And just like that, Bristol is up by three. I told you, these lead swings, it's like the Tigers go up by four. Then Bristol goes up by three or four. From deep, the three-pointer. It's good. Long ball. Michael Correa. And the game is tied at 76. Oh, my. Oh, my. 76-76. Keith, Mr. Tibbs, you're missing a good one here. Ten on the shot clock. Got to get something going to the basket. White. Oh, it looks like he's going to step back for three. It's way short. And Harris comes down with it. Ooh. Browder with a little floater. Can't get it to fall. And then Michael Correa in the paint draws the foul, but it's going to be on the floor. It's not going to be a shooting foul. And the Tigers will inbound from underneath their own basket. 6:09 to play in this one. This one has been a humdinger, that's for sure. Coming up on 6 minutes to play. DeLeon for three. Off the side of the rim. It seems like all of his shots are just going flat. Talking about Michael DeLeon. His last three shots have just been just coming up short. There's no rotation on that ball. He's shooting a flat shot right now. Probably not the best shot for the Tigers. Farnworth looking to come off a screen. Farnworth gets his shot blocked there by Patino. He got a piece of it. Harris thought about three. Gets it to the paint. Puts it up with the left hand. Goes around Petruski and lays it in. Boy, Harris and Browder, they've been amazing. Jumper in the corner by Petruski. Good job by Petruski. Nice find there by Farnworth, and it's 78-78. And the Tigers lose the ball out of bounds subsequently with 5:15 to play. Bristol with the basketball. Again, Bristol trying to hold their position here in Region 21. Looking for a home playoff game, a home tourney game. Petruski up and over Browder. Can't get it to fall. Rock with the rebound. Can't get the put back. And we're still tied at 78, ladies and gentlemen. Browder out of the post. Kicks it to Korea. Loose ball foul. Going for the ball was Morin. And he made contact with DeLeon. And that's the 16th foul on Bristol. One more, and they'll be in the penalty as well. They swing it into the corner. Korea for three. Kicking it to fall. Morin doing a good job rebounding. In transition, Rock lays it up and in. He's got 31 on the night. In transition. It all started with the rebound by Morin. And he's doing a good job of getting that rebound, corralling it, and keeping it over his head so the little guys don't smack it away. Bayhawks with the lead. Patino can't get it to fall. Yeah, Petruski got that one knocked away. Spinning in the lane, and how does he do it again? The floater. Browder, Shamar Browder. He's got 34 on the night. And this game is tied at 80. Holy cow, what a game. I'm gonna lose my voice. 3:55 to play. Here on the day after Valentine's Day. Happy Valentine's Day. To all you lovers out there. Hi, Mom. 3:55 to go, 80-80. Bristol trying to hold on to that number four spot as we wind down this season. This is the best time of year, folks. In college basketball, as we come down the stretch, 80-80, Bristol with the basketball. White being guarded closely by Geronimo Patino. And he loses the basketball. Patino with the steal. As he comes up the sideline. Kick in the corner, DeLeon. Again, that shot. Yeah, he's 0 for 4. He's 0 for 4 on his last four attempts from downtown. Can't drill it. 3:27. Anybody's ball game right now. It's been back and forth. Harris thought about three. He'll pull it back out. Bristol in zone, and they force a turnover. Ball goes out of bounds, and Bristol has the lead. Nice pass inside. Camden Morin with the basket. And it is 82-80. Under 3 minutes to go. Where would you rather be on a Thursday night? Packed house. Harris thought about three. Kicks it. Five on the shot clock. Going to the basket. Patino. And they're going to call a jump ball, I believe. It was Browder and Petruski wrestling for it. And it'll be Bayhawks basketball. 2:32 to play in this one. 82-80. Curran Farnsworth bringing the ball up for Bristol. You're watching Bayhawks basketball here on our YouTube, our Bayhawks YouTube station. Courtesy of FRC Media. Going to the basket is Curran Farnsworth. He'll draw the foul, and he'll try to extend this lead as we head into crunch time. Curran Farnsworth going to the line. Farnsworth takes his time, sinks the first free throw. Nothing but net. ...83-80. Farnsworth comes up short. Rebounded by DeLeon. You can't let Browder get into the paint. There he is. Shamar Browder kicks to the corner. DeLeon thought about it. The floater in the lane by Patino. Can't get it to fall. Petruski. Good job by Petruski. With a good rebound. Good rebound. Here's White, hands off to Farnsworth. 1:45 to go. Farnsworth goes into the paint, loses the basketball. And they're gonna say Harris knocked it away. Yeah, Farnsworth does a good job getting into the paint, had a clear lane, but Harris ripped it away, number 12. Petruski. The hook, the baby hook, he misses it. And it's gonna be Tiger basketball. One possession ball game. It's getting hot in here. The games just keep getting more important as this season goes on. Up fake. Korea goes up into the body of Petruski and gets it off the glass. I would have liked to have seen Petruski challenge that just a little bit more. Minute 8 to go. 83-82, 1 point lead for Bristol. And Farnsworth off the inbound pass. Loses the basketball out of bounds. That's a big turnover. That's a tough one. You can't let that happen. And now the Tigers have a chance to regain the lead in this seesaw back and forth crazy battle of these two NJCAA Region 21 rivals. Bayhawks come back away with it. You gotta protect the basketball. Morin to the basket. Browder in transition. DeLeon misses the dunk. DeLeon misses the dunk that. Oh, and they're gonna call Farnsworth with the foul? Wow, unbelievable. Aiden Rock will come into the game. He'll take the place of Marquise Pina. They got Petruski in there for size. Browder misses the free throw. And timeout. That's a good timeout by Coach Fernandes. Gather your team. You're playing a little bit out of sorts right now. Gather your team, get them under control, and you have the lead. And there's a 7-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock, so you essentially can hold on to the basketball. You just got to take care of the basketball right now if you're Bristol. Bristol. They need a big victory here. Yeah, you finish in that top four in the conference. I mean, you're gonna be guaranteed a playoff game. You're gonna be guaranteed a home. You're gonna be guaranteed a home tournament game in Region 21. Bristol. They've reached Region 21 finals in the past under Coach Rob Delalu. However, they've never advanced to the national tournament. So that is the goal. That is the dream. 83-82. They'll have to go the length of the court. Tigers matching up man-to-man, full court. Marquise Pina back in for Bristol. Morin with the basketball. You got to get it to Farnworth. You got to get it to your point guard, your ball handler. Again, the Tigers don't have to foul. 7 on the shot clock. Oh, nice pass underneath to Farnworth. What a pass there by Marcus White. 12.4 seconds to go. Boy, that was that big. Don't foul. Stolen away by Morin. Morin. Oh, smart. That was smart by Morin to take it back out. Morin, that's it. Bristol's a winner. What a steal there by Morin and the wherewithal to hold on to the basketball, and that's it. The Bayhawks are winners on Bayhawk night, 85-82, and a tremendous game played here. And your Bayhawks player of the game will be none other than Aiden Rock here on Bayhawks sophomore night. For David Cardoza, Michelle D, and Stephen Reese, you've been watching Bayhawks basketball here on FRC Media. The Bayhawks win 85-82. Good night, everybody, from Taunton.